In the past decade, African leaders have taken major strides to address in a comprehensive and holistic manner the challenges of conflict prevention, management, and resolution on the continent. While the number of conflicts have been significantly reduced, and important advances have been made thanks to the collective determination and efforts of Africa, far too many African countries remain trapped in a vicious cycle of conflict with its attendant deadly consequences.
As you know, African leaders recognize that peace and security are cornerstone of a thriving, integrated Africa. It is in this context that on 31st August 2009, the heads of state and government of the African Union, meeting in Tripoli, declared the year 2010 to be the year of peace and security on the continent.
African leaders are joining hands with other stakeholders and partners to make peace happen in 2010 and beyond. Some notable African personalities have already demonstrated their commitment to this noble cause. The 2010 Year of Peace and Security in Africa campaign will culminate on Peace Day, 21st September. The AU is using Peace Day as the principal focus for all activities to show that permanent peace is possible. On 21st September, there should be no violence, no conflict, no fighting. All Africans should experience peace simultaneously. Across Africa, on Peace Day, there will be cessation of hostilities and violence, intensified distribution of humanitarian supplies and materials, 1 minute of silence for peace at an agreed time. Members of the armed forces engaged in community development activities. Football games to bring communities together around one common goal, peace. And peace lessons and other activities in learning institutions. If we can make peace happen for one day, then why not for a week, or a month, or even a year? And indeed, why not for life?
War and deadly conflicts have social and economic consequences long after the fighting has ended, with women and children bearing the greatest brunt. Peace requires more than the absence of war.
Peace building is a multidimensional in its approach. It warrants tackling the disarmament of combatants, the rebuilding of communities, the design and implementation of justice mechanisms, the provision of relief services, and the promotion of inclusive governance and national development.
Good governance is now taking roots. The mechanisms of dealing with conflicts are becoming much stronger, both at the African Union level and at the regional level. These are the prospects for the future of the continent.
I think in 15 years from now, we will have an Africa that has sustained peace. I think we see that happening in so many places with African decision about moving to more democracy, participation, more importantly, promoting development to be able to arrest poverty.
The year of peace and security is not just about one day. After Peace Day, a program of education and awareness raising will continue in order to drive momentum and enthusiasm and to educate people about the positive benefits of peace, to inspire them to continue to work for permanent peace in Africa. What will you do to make peace happen?